You think you've seen full meltdown mode until you see full meltdown mode. And that's the media right now continuing their racism narrative in the wake of President Trump's recent immigration comments. But does everyone in the media share the same outrage? Let's get a reaction from our panel of radio talk show hosts. Not enough microphones for this crew. Host of the Wilkow Majority, Andrew Wilkow, Fox News contributor David Webb, radio host and Fox News contributor Tammy Bruce, and the host of Steele and Unger on Sirius XM, Rick Unger. Good morning to all of you. Thanks for being here.
You're not going to have time to talk.
I'm not even going to try to talk. But I'm going to start with Rick, our resident liberal here. Are you hysterical about what's happened?
I don't get hysterical, so I'm not sure I can say that. Look, there are obviously some problems with the comment on a lot of fronts, and Andrew and I were talking about it earlier.
But you have problems with the comments. I mean, it seems that the expletive word is CNN's favorite word right now.
Yeah, look, I mean, it's something that you certainly have to wish wasn't said, because I think the president should have known it would escape that meeting. Now, I'll tell you what, I am putting a little blame on the leakers, and I'll tell you why. I think the most, aside from the moral issues, and everybody has their own point of view on that, there is a foreign policy issue here. You know, there are parts of sub-Sahara in Africa that are the fastest growing economies in the world. People that we need to do business with. We want our American firms doing business. But that coming out will definitely not be helpful.
Tammy, does it matter that that comment was made in the context of a lottery system? So, yeah, you can separate countries from people, but what if you're not getting necessarily to choose who those people are?
Well, look, it was a comment made in the larger construct of who we're bringing in, mm-hmm. and what we want here in this country. And the issue is, for the people, whether they're from Haiti or anywhere else, which, by the way, there's now an admission Haiti was never mentioned, of course. That was just an add-on because, of course, it's more dramatic. But it really is for the people who've come here from those countries. They're the ones who agree. They've left those countries for a reason.
Well,
and getting here for that dynamic, a realization that their lives can be better. But this is a larger conversation. It's why we have government. They should be having it. But the reaction has been really is denigrated the nature of why you have those conversations in private in the first place. Look, the Democrats were getting Donald Trump to agree with them on DACA and certain mm-hmm. things, and they turn around and do this.
But
so it's going to be now a problem for the Democrats. Maybe the president should rethink those kinds of meetings because of this kind of thing happening.
Well, how much is the salty language also a reaction to a bad deal that the president had presented to as well?
It's a reaction to a bad deal and all those other things. I'm going to agree with Rick on something, which is the leakers are the problem here. Look, go inside White Houses, close the doors, and you have frank talk. The problem is you've got people now who take that frank talk out of the room. And let me ask the obvious question. What was wrong about some of the things he said? Put the expletive aside and look at countries broken down by despotism, by warlords, by criminal cartels. This isn't about people or landscape. It's about the leadership of those countries. $500 million raised to help Haiti. Look at the state of this country. Democrats are fighting to keep Haitians on TPS here, temporary protected status. Well, if Haiti's so great, why do these people not want to run back? The problem is, you look at Africa, we're out of 50-something countries, 32 or so of them are broken down with Islamism, warlords, al-Shabaab, various forms of strife, and they're economically, I mean, it's actual tragedy.
Well, what if temporary protected status is never temporary? I mean, what the president is pointing out is these things that are temporary policies eventually just slide into becoming permanent.
I'm gonna put the cherry on this. If you were to sneak that camera into an Upper West Side of Manhattan dinner party, mm-hmm. and the topic was Trump voters, states that went for Trump, you know, the Midwest, anything between the George Washington Bridge and the Golden Gate Bridge, mm-hmm. what kind of language do you think those Upper West Side of Manhattan Rick Unger types? what do you think the Rick Unger types have?
Really, you don't come on. No. I've talked with you.
Really?
No, really. You got to be careful here. You know, this is one of the memes that's trying to deflect this thing. Nobody's angry at the president for using a cuss word. We all
really?
Cuss.
Yes, they are.
No, they
yes,
aren't.
They're obsessed.
They're angry.
They can't get enough of
no,
it.
They're angry about the context he used it in. Look, people.
We're referring to Haiti?
People
no.
emigrate.
They got a Jeopardy question.
Wait. People emigrate to other countries because they think they're going to have a better life. I got to tell you, I grew up in a town in Ohio that everybody used to refer to with the same exact word.
Let me just add, watch the hand. We got one more minute.
Tammy, go ahead. We've only got 1 minute left. Go ahead.
But let me just say that the left isn't angry about anything. This is an opportunity. They're opportunistic. they see something that's going to help them gain some credibility with their base. They've never cared about this dynamic. It's been the UN, it's been Barack Obama that's made the world a dumpster fire, that has created these problems. They're not suddenly concerned about these regions. Haiti has been out there being abused and ruined because of the global international system.
Sure.
They have nothing that any of these liberals care about, and so it's been abandoned. So they don't suddenly care about any of this. It's all theater.
Seconds, David.
The bottom line on this is, to Andrew's point, you've got the crew that made fun of it. Let's look at the tea parties and teabagging, which was their favorite word over
obsessed.
At MSNBC. They were obsessed with it, and now they're offended by language. This is all about going after Trump.
It's all BS.
Trump literally could cure cancer. They'd say he created it so he could cure it.
All right, I don't know about you, America, but I want more of this, which is why we're going to have you guys stick around, and we're going to do round two of this as well. Rick, you're a little outnumbered, but we love you anyway.